This is a brief introduction to decision modeling. You've probably seen a model house, a model car, or a model plane. In essence, a model is a representation of the real thing. It could be physical or abstract. But here, we're mainly interested in mathematical or quantitative models. Therefore, in this context, a model is a quantitative construct or mathematical representation of a scenario. So what does that mean? Suppose a business sells its products at $6 per unit, then their total revenue can be written as 6x, where x is the number of units sold. This is a mathematical model which we will refer to as a decision model because it can provide insights into solving decision problems that the business might face. Here is another model that shows the relationship between list price of an item, the rate of discount, and the net price a customer pays. We will classify decision models into two main types, deterministic and probabilistic models. Deterministic means input values are known with certainty. For example, we can know for sure that our selling price is $6 per unit, or that we only have 20 parking spots for customers, or that our store opens 6 days a week, or that our warehouse space is 40,000 square feet. On the other hand, probabilistic, or what we also call stochastic models, have uncertain input values or data. For example, how many units are customers going to buy this week? Is the government going to raise key interest rate? Is the economy going to be stable, or will there be a recession next quarter? In essence, the input values can only be estimated with some probability. Now, these input values or data can either be qualitative or quantitative. Qualitative, if they only describe characteristics or qualities that are usually non-numeric. For example, customer attitude, government regulation, or store location. And quantitative, if they are numeric, such as hours of production, units sold, and total revenue. Now, let's examine the three main steps in decision modeling, which are formulation, solution, and interpretation. Under formulation, we first define the problem. Suppose the problem is to determine profit. Then we can develop a profit model, say, total revenue minus total cost. Suppose selling price per unit is $5, then total revenue is 5x. Suppose fixed cost is $2,000 and variable cost is $2 per unit, then total cost is $2,000 plus 2x. Next, we acquire inputs data. Suppose our input value X is 500 units. Then, on the solution, we're going to develop a solution and test to see if it is correct or if it meets our objective. If we solve for profit here, we see that we have a loss of 500. Since we don't want a loss, we can retrace our steps back to the model to see where changes can be made. Let us tweak the model slightly by increasing the selling price per unit to $6 and change the input data to produce, say, 800 units. Then our profit will be 1,200. If that meets the objective, then we can move on to interpretation. This is where we analyze the result and do what is called sensitivity or what-if analysis. Sensitivity simply refers to how the model responds to changes. That is, what if we reduce the variable cost per unit to 80 cents? Or increase production to 1,000 units, or if fixed costs increase to 3,000, what will happen to profit? So sensitivity analysis is useful in analyzing the best and worst case scenarios in order to make a good decision. We can thus go back to the model to see if we need to make changes to accommodate the new assumptions. And if we like what we have overall, we can implement the solution. In conclusion, while quantitative models are very systematic in nature, business decision processes are usually non-linear as there are typically many factors to consider. A business may decide not to make the highest profit in the short term because of long-term goals or because of company's values or government regulations. And that's a very brief introduction to decision modeling. Thanks for watching.